In this video, not only are we going to build a pretty cool AI automation that adjusts your light brightness automatically, but more importantly, you're going to get a real feel for how NAN and Home Assistant can work together. Now, NAN is one of those visual automation tools that can look super intimidating at first, you know, with all its nodes and options, but honestly, most workflows just boil down to a simple trigger, process, and execute model. So here's the game plan for this automation. Whenever you walk into a room, a presence sensor will detect you, and then an AI will decide on the perfect light brightness based on the current time of day. All right, first things first. The official Home Assistant add-on store doesn't have NAN built in, so we need to add the NAN repository first. Don't worry, I'll have the link for that down in the description. Once you've added it, just search for NAN in the add-on store, hit install, and it'll pull down the Docker image and set everything up. Now, hold on, before you start it up, hop into the configuration tab and set your time zone. Save that, and then you can start NAN. Okay, let's start building our NAN workflow. And the first node we need is the trigger. But you'll see a message that says no Home Assistant triggers available. I looked around the NAN interface for a while, and yeah, there's no way to directly use a sensor state change as a trigger. Your only options are schedule or webhook. Since we need to know when our present sensor changes state, webhook is our guy. And right away, we hit our first snag. It turns out any Home Assistant node needs a long-lived access token to actually communicate with NAN. To fix this, just go to your Home Assistant user profile, find the security section at the bottom, and create a new token. Copy it, then back in NAN, you'll need to punch in your Home Assistant's IP address, the port, and paste that access token right in. That should clear up the error. But after you do that, you'll notice there are two webhook URLs, a test URL and a production URL. So which one do we use and how do we even use it? First, let's change the HTTP method to post and give it a custom path. Let's say light brightness. You'll see both URLs update. Now, to test if this thing actually works, you hit listen for test event and it'll just sit there waiting. But here's the thing. When I went to test it using a curl command from my PC on the same network, it just wouldn't connect. Not the test URL, not the production URL, nothing. I looked at the hostname, which was Home Assistant, and I thought, okay, that's probably the issue. So I checked the NAN and realized that HAOS gives every add-on a unique hostname. I thought, aha, I'll swap that in, but nope, still nothing. After trying a bunch of things, I finally figured it out. You have to manually edit the test URL and replace Home Assistant with the actual IP of your HAOS. Once I ran that, boom, NAN finally gave me the node executed successfully pop-up, and the production URL showed workflow was started. We finally got the right webhook URL. All right, next up, the second node, the process step. This, of course, is where the AI comes in. Search for the AI agent module, and for this, we'll select define below. In the prompt, we'll give it some instructions, basically tell it to act like a lighting designer, get the current time, figure out if it's morning, afternoon, or night, and then pick a brightness level. Next, for the chat model, you know, DeepSeek just upgraded their models and cut their API prices in half, so I figured today's a good day to give them a shot. Just drop in your DeepSeek API key, and this node is good to go. And finally, the execute node. Find the call a service node and drag it in. We'll set the domain to light and the service to turn on. Lastly, we need to add two attributes. First is the entity ID for your smart light and Home Assistant. And the second is the brightness attribute itself, along with the value we get from our AI. And just like that, our NAN workflow is done. You can flip the switch to activate it and it'll be live. But we're not quite finished. We still need to create a simple automation back in Home Assistant to actually trigger this NAN workflow. Hopefully, this is something they'll streamline in the future. Over in your configuration.yaml file, you need to create a REST command that will call our NAN webhook address. And make sure you use the production URL from your NAN workflow for this. Then finally, in your automations UI, you create a new one. The trigger will be our presence sensor changing state from clear to detected. And the action will be to call that REST command we just made. So now when I walk in front of the sensor, the automation fires, it calls the NAN webhook, which triggers our NAN workflow, and the light should turn on with the perfect AI-chosen brightness. So look, what I showed you today was just my process, you know? The result of me tinkering and debugging this whole thing. But you should totally take this and run with it. Swap in a different AI model, make it change the light color too, or add way more conditions. That's the real fun of Home Assistant. I'm super curious to see what other cool automations you guys can come up with using this three-step model. If you built something awesome, you have to share it in the comments below. As always, your likes and subscribes are what keep me motivated to explore new stuff in Home Assistant. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.